Hello my dear friends, welcome back again in the new video of Power Learning Channel. So in today's video our topic is ACB. ACB stands for air circuit breaker. In this video we will watch about the complete wiring diagram of ACB, types of ACB, what are the accessories used in ACB, how to operate manually and how to operate automatically. If you watch this video completely, in the end of this video you will learn that how to operate this complicated type of ACBs very easily. So my dear friends, my name is Muzammil and you are watching Power Learning Channel. On this channel we are making many videos about generator, power system, synchronizing system, control panel wiring. So there is many videos available on my channel related to this. If you are new on this channel, kindly like, share and subscribe our channel. So my dear friends, ACBs we are using in different application for different type of use. ACB ratings start from 630 amps to 6300 amps. In between this we have different ratings like 630, 800 amps, 1000 amps, 1250 amps, 1600 amps, 2000 amps, 2500 amps, 2200 amps, 2000 amps and 6300 amps. In this kind of ACBs we have two type of breakers. One is fixed type and one is removable type. Removable type we will say draw out, and fixed type which is fixed inside the frame is called fixed. Draw out type we can remove it easily, and fixed type we cannot do it without removing of bus bars. In the video you are seeing we are charging the breaker manually. This breaker you can charge and discharge by hand and also by motor. So now in front of you these are trip coils. These coils are very important for the breaker. Without this coil you cannot operate the breaker automatically. These coils we are using to turn on and turn off the breaker. These coils are called shunt opening and shunt closing coils. Normally in these coils we have different ratings like 220 volt, 12 volt, 24 volt AC-DC. So my dear friends, now you see in front of you we have breakers. This is 3 pole ACB breakers and this is the rear connection of the ACB. In ACB we have many different kind of connection. Now you see this is our sync panel which we are preparing cabinet to cabinet, and we have installed digital controller. So we can control our breaker with digital controller as well as electrically and mechanically. So now you see in front of you we have Schneider breaker which is written all connection in front. So I will explain you all the connection in the drawing, how to make the connection. But now you see this is OF1, OF2, OF3. These are auxiliary contacts. So here you see this is master packed NT12H1. And here is the micro logic 2.0. this is the basic type of the micro logic using for electronic trip. Also some people saying to electronic trip. Mostly we are seeing in industry we have molded case small circuit breakers, but small circuit breaker cannot be used in bigger application or higher current rating application. So my dear friends, now in front of us we have the point to point remote on off function wiring diagram of a ACB. In ACB, we first of all we know what accessories we have which will help us to operate the ACB automatically. So now you see here we have first one symbol MCH, one is MX and other one is XF. Other than this we have spring charge, opening order, closing order, ready to close, fault open indication, okay, and closed indication. Also if you see here we have push button, opening order and closing order. Other than this, if you see, the control circuit is only depending on two wires. One is phase wire and one is neutral wire. Also, you can see it is positive and negative because coils and motors are available also in DC supply. So, my dear friends, so now we know that to operate our ACB, manual ACB in automatic mode, we need motor, charge motor, we need MX coil, we need XF coil. MX means opening order coil and XF means closing order coil. So, how we will connect, first we have two wires, one is phase wire, one is neutral wire, okay, in the circuit. And as you see in the MCH we have terminal number B2 and B1. If we will give supply directly to B2 and B1, it's mean once the power is on our motor will automatically charge immediately. And there is behind under the MCH there is contact CH. Once the motor is fully charged this contact will automatically open and give the signal to indication lamp that spring is fully charged. On the B3 terminal we will connect indication lamp which will show the spring charge is fully charged now and the motor is ready to use, the breaker is ready to use. After that we will see opening order and closing order. What is mean by opening and closing order? Opening order means to open the breaker, to off the breaker, and closing means to turn on the breaker and to close the breaker. To close the breaker means to turn on. So it's mean we need two coil to turn on the breaker and to turn off the breaker. For turning on, we need closing order. For turning off, we need opening order. So the opening order coil is called MX and the closing order coil is called XF. So in this way, we will put two push button, one on opening order and one on closing order. So once we press the closing order button, so the breaker will get on. And after that, once we press the opening order button, the breaker get open. So in this way, our breaker is working now. Other than this, we have here SDE and there is a one contact and fault open. SDE, this is the built-in auxiliary contact to show in case if the breaker is tripped. Shutdown, breaker is tripped. This contact is only we will use only in case of breaker shutting down. Only if the breaker is tripped internally. So then this contact will close and it will give signal on the indication lamp. Now the breaker is open. Other than this, we have OF1. OF1 is an auxiliary contact. Auxiliary contact we will use in many application, but here to explain you simply, we use it for breaker opening and closing status. If the breaker is open, it will show us on the indication lamp that now the breaker status is open. And in case once the breaker is closed, this normally open contact will get closed with number 14, 11 and 14. So it will show us that the indication closed is open and the breaker is closed. So my dear friend, this is simple and easy explanation of spring charge motors point to point diagram of ACB. If you have any confusion or if you need more clarification on this, you can comment us below and inshallah in next video we will explain you more about it. Thanks for watching Power Learning Channel. Have a nice day. Assalamu alaikum.